talk about courage and bravery, but it doesn't often apply to someone who is just 5 years old. So it's absolutely incredible to be able to tell you this morning about young Queenslander Sophie Holmes. Now, she's been nominated through the Courier Mail newspaper for a Pride of Australia medal for jumping into a swimming pool and saving her little brother's life. Mm. And we're delighted to have Sophie and her mother, Vicki, in our Brisbane studio. Good morning, Vicki. Thank you so much for joining us. Now, your family must be incredibly proud of Sophie.
We are. We can't believe her courage that she showed to save Blake. So she's our hero. Mm. Hey, Soph. Oh, yeah. She's a bit shy.
Sophie, it's good to have you with us on television. Can you tell us what happened when your little brother fell into the pool? What did you do?
Saved him.
You did.
Saved
him. But you jumped in the pool, didn't you?
Yes.
And then you'd learnt some life-saving at your swimming classes and you swam with him over to the side of the pool, is that right?
That's right, yeah.
Oh, my God,
oh, you're so very, cute. You're very brave and very good, aren't you?
I just absolutely adore the Pride of Australia Awards. I think that is just the most beautiful, touching thing. I tear up a little bit every time I hear stories like yours, Vicki. Can you tell us, because I am in constant fear of endangering my young son's life and I feel like, you know, he's seconds from death at all times. It's like, you know, you're just on suicide watch with a youngster flopping around on the floor. How do you teach your kids to be able to, you know, act this way in moments of crisis? How do you teach them to have those incredible instincts and then the skills to know what to do?
I think it was just Sophie. She's just such a brave little girl. But basically, she's been swimming since she was 9 months old, and she saw Blake fall into the pool and she swam straight up. She was getting a dive stick and she basically just got him and she just said, swim to the side, swim to the side, swim to the side. And she took him to the side and pulled him out, and I was a mess. I was sitting right there, took the hooded towel off his face and she said, it's okay, Mummy. But you can't I think it's just ingrained in them from swimming from such a young age, and I think our swimming lessons have definitely paid off. So, she's our little... Definitely.
And Sophie, so you like Peso from the Octonauts. I think you're even braver than Peso. Tell me... your brother, what has he said to you?
What has Blake said to you about you saving him?
Mm-mm.
Don't know. I love you, Fofi.
Oh. That's beautiful.
Yeah, yeah.
How did it happen that Blake fell into the pool?
Well, Sophie was diving for dive sticks and he had a dive stick and threw it in and he toppled over and fell in. And then Sophie saw him floundering and I just heard, Blake, Blake. And she put her arms around him and swam into the side and calm me down. So,
it's a lovely
champion,
story.
Hey?
It's terrifying how easily it can happen.
Vicki, I was just about to ask that question, is the fact that you can be there with them, watching them, and it happens in a split second, and this has happened to me before, where they actually call it the silent killer because you don't actually hear a big splash. It just happens within a second and they're gone.
Mm. Exactly. And if he hadn't have had a hooded towel on, the other towel would have fallen off and he could have made himself free to the side. Mm. But because it was the weight of the water, it was pulling him down, that's what the emergency was, and that's where Sophie saw him floundering.
And Vicki...
So it is...
Yeah, incredible the way, as you say, it can happen so quickly. Now, you must feel so proud, nominated for the Pride of Australia. Your little girl.
I know. My mum actually wrote in to the newspaper and... Mum said, we might not hear anything, but then the journalist contacted me and she said, Vicki, I got goosebumps all over me when the story came across my desk. We have to interview you, send a photographer out and write up the story. And it came out yesterday and we goosebumps. We couldn't be more proud. Hey, Soph. Yeah.
Well done. Absolutely great story. Sophie and Vicki, thank you so much for joining us and best of luck for the awards.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye.
What a great story.
I'm just such a cynical old hack, but I still get a bit teary when I hear those stories.
And I think it's great that we're nominating and recognising these extraordinary Australians. Mm.
Well, they're ordinary Australians. That's
they're
the best part.
Awards.
They're just doing extraordinary
things. We were involved with them last year. Yeah, they're great awards.
young, responsible Australian girls that have become responsible about that age. I've noticed with grandchildren, and it kicks in because they've got to face a lifetime of dealing with us goofballs. Yeah, yeah.
Now, nominations close on the 29th of July for the Pride of Australia medal. You can find out all the details and nomination your local legends by going to theprideofaustralia.com.au.